Given the current health crisis, cruising has been suspended until at least mid-May and probably longer. In order for cruising to resume, cruise lines would certainly be required to implement new policies and adhere to stricter protocols to ensure the health and safety of their guests. While no one knows for sure what this will entail, we expect cruising to be somewhat different once we return to the seas. I'm DB from EatSleepCruise.com, and in this video, we share some of our predictions in the 15 ways that cruising will change once the suspension is lifted. Prior to the global suspension of cruising, some cruise lines began to implement enhanced medical screenings prior to embarkation. It's a sure bet that these elements will remain in place for the foreseeable future once cruising resumes. These measures include more thorough health questionnaires, as well as temperature checks of all guests prior to embarkation, as well as upon return from ports. It's plausible to believe that these same measures will be conducted among the staff as well. Immediately preceding the cruise ban, some lines also started implementing restrictions on passengers that were allowed to sail. The two major restrictions were based on recent travel history and cruiser age and health. It's likely that these same guidelines will be used once cruising resumes. Most significantly, cruisers over the age of 70 may still be required to submit a fit to travel letter from their doctors, certifying that they are healthy enough to depart on the voyage. Most certainly, there'll be an increased sanitation protocols in place for public areas once the cruise suspension is lifted. This will likely include a more regimented schedule of cleaning high traffic areas, like elevator buttons, handrails, bar tops, gym equipment, among other areas. Also, there will likely be an increased emphasis on hand washing, as well as increased hand sanitizer stations throughout the ship. This might also mean that bar staff and wait staff would be subjected to increased sanitation measures between serving guests. Unfortunately, social distancing might also continue to some extent on cruise ships. How this will play out remains to be seen. However, we suspect that cruise ships might purposely sail at reduced capacity, at least initially. This could also mean limiting the number of guests allowed into certain food and entertainment venues. It is also possible that more cruise lines could move towards a full reservation system to avoid overcrowding in the main theater or dining rooms. While many believe that cruising will be deeply discounted following the cruise suspension to lure guests back, we have yet to see significantly reduced prices for future cruises. While lines may reduce sticker price, there will certainly be increased pricing for other add-on items like specialty dining, beverage packages, and shore excursions. Guests have already been reporting up to 40% increases on drink packages for Royal Caribbean, now putting them on par with Norwegian Cruise Line. At that pricing, it will definitely make it difficult for us to justify purchasing one of these packages. Most likely, the cruise lines will incrementally roll out ships in the fleet, starting with the most popular vessels. In addition to temporarily sailing a reduced fleet, we suspect cruise lines might sell off older ships or delay the production of new ships and ship refurbishments. Some cruise lines have already announced such postponements. We're scheduled to sail on the new Odyssey of the Seas in November and already delayed our Carnival Mardi Gras to January of 2021. So we're keeping our fingers crossed that there are no delays in these deliveries. Along with sailing at reduced capacity of ships, we suspect these ships will also sail to a reduced number of regions and ports. Even within region, some ports of call may continue to deny cruise ships from docking for an extended period of time. While the Alaska cruise season has already been delayed until at least July, we suspect that European cruises will also be further delayed. It makes sense that cruises will resume in areas like the Bahamas or the Caribbean first, sticking closer to home for the time being. Perhaps we could even see cruises to nowhere, or just private islands making a return at first. While most cruise lines have eased cancellation policies and extended the Cruise with Confidence programs through at least the summer, we wouldn't be surprised if these relaxed policies are in effect for much longer. This will help ease cruiser concerns, making them more likely to book a cruise. And let's face it, with all the negative media attention recently, many people will be skeptical about cruising for quite a while. This would also help to eliminate the risk of sick passengers trying to board the ship just so they don't lose out on the funds paid for the voyage. With many of the recent outbreaks occurring on cruise ships due to transfer of staff members between ships, it's highly likely that cruise lines will aim to keep the crew more consistent on vessels. The logistics of this will have to be addressed, but it could mean longer contracts for crew members. This also raises the question of whether crew members from certain regions of the world who have returned home will be allowed back to work right away once cruising resumes. If this pandemic has taught us anything, is that there needs to be higher level of healthcare available on cruise ships. This would include increasing the number of medical professionals and increasing the availability of medical equipment and PPE to ensure that cruise ships are capable of safely treating health issues in both passengers and crew when they arise. While most cruise lines implemented a no self-service policy as part of the increased sanitation measures immediately preceding this global health crisis, most lines do ordinarily have self-service areas, like buffets, soft-serve ice cream stations near the pools, or freestyle soda machines. It's likely that these venues will now be staffed by crew members. This might mean that more cruise lines will follow suit of Virgin Voyages, offering more of a food court setup as opposed to a true buffet. In a similar fashion, we could also see cruise lines returning to more single-use and disposable items on board. While many brands have recently aimed to eliminate all single-use plastics, we could see the return of disposable cups, silverware, and bathroom toiletries. It is possible for cruise lines to provide such single-use items that are still environmentally friendly, similar to the water bottles on Norwegian Cruise Line. While most cruise lines do assign boarding times upon completion of the pre-cruise check-in process, few actually enforce these times. In fact, one of our biggest embarkation day tips is to always arrive to the cruise terminal early. Unfortunately, this may change. Firstly, embarkation might start later to allow for increased sanitation between sailings. Or, it is possible that a 7-day cruise will now be shortened to allow for 24-hour turnaround times. Further, an easy means of crowd control in the terminal would be to allow only those passengers with the proper boarding time access into the facilities. In the light of all the recent health issues on board cruise ships, it's likely that travel insurance policies and coverage will change. Primarily, it's likely that the cost of these plans will increase. It's also possible that broader travel insurance plans like our annual plan may no longer cover cruising. Could these plans continue to cover items like travel delays and lost luggage, but offer reduced medical coverage? It's also possible that travel insurance providers could require increased screening process or have a tiered pricing system based on your age and other comorbidities. We see all of these as definite possibilities. Finally, it's inevitable that cruiser behavior will change, at least temporarily, given the recent circumstances. While cruise addicts like ourselves will be willing to hop back on board right away, many casual cruisers will be more skeptical. Cruisers with underlying health conditions might also be more hesitant to cruise right away. Even avid cruisers might avoid traveling to certain regions of the world in the next year or two. Potentially, cruisers might forgo mega ships that have higher passenger capacities and opt for smaller ships. This health crisis might also impact the passenger demographic, changing it significantly. And we can see that first-time cruisers that make up a large portion of every cruise might delay cruising, at least in the near future. And there you have it. Those are the 15 ways we think cruising will change once the cruise suspension is lifted. But of course, we'd love to hear from you. Do you agree with our assessment? Let us know in the comments below if your cruise habits will change going forward. I'm DB from eatsleepcruise.com, and if you enjoyed this video, we'd really appreciate it if you gave it a big thumbs up. If you're new to the channel or have been lurking around for a while and haven't done so, what are you waiting for? Make sure to subscribe down below and to also click the notification icon. That way you get updated each week when we put out a brand new cruise video. You can also say hi to us all over social media at Eat Sleep Cruise. And thanks again for watching.